That's what saved the Titanic.
We are in the land of the Vikings.
Never seen anything like this. This is the only world like this, and we're still on Earth.
We're trying to find some river systems that haven't been explored, or if they have, very few people have been up them.
All this water, I would bet money that there's got to be some fish.
We want to try to catch the biggest char in these waters.
We call them fire bellies. That is the fish that dreams are made of.
They can be very challenging to find, but that's what we want to do. We want to go on the hunt and find them.
Believe it or not, this guy, he does not do very good in boats on the ocean. Yeah, once a boat starts doing this from side to side, Jay might be down there.
It's a serious situation. Everybody laughs about it. Everybody thinks they're pretty funny. Pretty funny. But old puke master Jay, not very excited about this situation.
We have heard rumors of just some huge char in Greenland. We're gonna cruise 200 miles up the coast to this remote river system to see if we can find these big Arctic char.
Greenland is enormous.
Yeah.
Everything is so far apart.
Our boat captain, Eric, he's Inuit. He has lived here all of his life.
Don't go out in the barn stand like this. It's bad luck.
He is just a badass dude. I mean, the knowledge that he has about this land where he's from is mind-blowing.
They're like Viking or Norse ruins or anything around in this area?
Yes. Approximately 1,000 years ago, our ancestors came to Greenland in the northern part. At the same time, Norse came to Greenland from Iceland in the southern part, and eventually the two cultures would meet right here in the fjord. The main reason why was to gather tusk from the narwhal and the walrus. In fact, not far from here, we will have a very small island. On this tiny little island, there's a kind of a little cave. Inside of that cave, there's a stone, and Norse carved in his name in runes. And the markings would be at least 700 years ago.
Oh, wow. I've got Norse blood running through my veins, so. Yeah, check out where the ancestors hung out.
This is Viking Central.
And here are the runes. Not very clear, but those that know about this will read the name Ingvat.
Ingvat.
Yeah, which is a very Viking-ish name.
There is such a drive inside of me to explore.
Top of the world, boys.
That's right. Top of the world.
This is badass. Yeah, look at this.
Pretty spectacular. There's more to see, and there's more fish in this world that you need to go and visit and to explore yourself.
Let's go do this.
The Arctic char, we have that in many streams in Greenland. One way I really like to catch them is by hand.
By hand?
Yeah, by
Say
hand.
Say what?
This is an old traditional way of catching it. I will teach you how to do it.
We came here to catch huge Arctic char on fly, but to catch some small ones by hand, yeah, we got time for that.
Apparently, we don't need to bring any rods with us because we've got two hands.
Lightning.
And
faster lightning.
See the char?
Ooh, fish everywhere in here.
You stick down your hand, hold it like this, and get it out of the water as fast as possible and just throw it on land.
What?
Let me demonstrate for you how it's done.
Yeah. You might want to, just a little demonstration. I mean, it's probably a different tactic that you use here in Greenland.
Eric's talking about how he can catch char with his hands. They're like, yeah, okay, bud.
Get out of here! Get out of here! You literally go into sneak attack pose and you're dragging yourself across the ground and then you're sticking your hand into this ice cold water and you move your hand so slowly that these fish think that your hand is actually another fish because you're just rubbing your hand all the way up the back of that fish until you can reach down and grab it.
Yeah! Oh, you got one!
Yeah!
My total primal Neanderthal instinct is totally kicked in right there, and I was just like, I need food!
There we go!
Look at the color on that fish, dude.
Yeah, dude!
Oh! No way!
Hey, Chris, I think you're the last one left that hasn't got a fish yet.
I don't have the patience.
You must not be very hungry.
I can feel those little bastards in there.
Oh, bust out the gun show. What do you got? What do you pack? Oh, don't rip your shirt.
No more games here. Oh, now there's one right here. Here's a big one. I got you. Come to Papa.
We can eat, boys! You got the smallest one of the bunch, dude. That was awesome.
Man, I can't believe that just went down.
Have you guys ever seen anything like that before? I mean, I like hooking them on flies and all, but that's pretty fun.
That was cool.
Catching char by hand was awesome. And I can't wait for a chance to catch some huge ones as we go further inland.
An Arctic char in spawning colors. That is the only fish that I wanted to catch in Greenland was that fish. And I just kept trying. This guy must be one cool cucumber. Because if there's anybody that can agitate someone, it's me.
Finally hooked this thing in the mouth.
I was just right on top of him, and then, bam, had him. Oh,
you're running.
I was running down the bank as fast as I could. I'm tripping, I'm falling on these holes, and I must have went down 150 yards.
Come on, baby, show me that fire belly.
There's a little tributary, and managed to get the fish over into some shallow water and land it.
Look at the colors on that.
This is why we came. We found it.
Have you ever seen anything like that?
Wow, look at those teeth.
Woo! Yeah! Last day, final countdown. The sun came out. We catch the biggest char I've ever caught in my entire life. That's it. Done. I don't need any more. I'm ready to leave this country. This beautiful country.
I love this place, but I am so ready to get out of Greenland. The mix of freezing cold temperatures, rain, snow, slush, and ice. This was an ass kicker.
Greenland is like nowhere else in the world.